L'escalator.
L'escalator, vas-y, l'escalator, on est bon? Allez, vas-y. Ah, E-I-O, vas-y, c'est parti.
Hello everyone. Before continuing, please note that this video is being made possible by Denon, a brand of the Sound United Group. For more than 110 years, Denon offered a full line of home cinema amplifiers on the edge of sound and video technology. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to take advantage of the new IMAX Enhanced format and especially explain what it brings to you. So stay with us until the end. The result is simply amazing. Hello everyone, today you're joining us for a new installation, which is gonna be exceptional. Why is it gonna be exceptional? Because on the one hand, we're in Lyon, but hey, that's not what makes things exceptional. We're a few kilometers away from Lyon, we're at Emmanuel and Anne's house. So it's exceptional because you have a gigantic red dog here, and this doesn't happen in every house, so look at it, it's magnificent. You're gonna see it again, so... It's a great frame. In addition, it's really sunny. Beautiful days are coming. We're with Urkan, who joined us to do the plasterboard. He's our new official appointed plasterer at AV Concept Products. He's Urkan. Say hello. Hello, welcome, Urkan, and welcome to you. Yeah, here's Yves, who joined us for this installation, and Marwan, who, as usual, he's already here. He's passing all the cables. So we've already made really, really good progress on this installation. It's Monday, and we have 5 days to do this installation from scratch. Everything is happening in a living room. You can see how it is inside. So here we're gonna have 3 speakers integrated into the ceiling, just in front of a projection screen. These 3 speakers are gonna spit the sound directly towards you, so these are gonna be the only speakers that you're gonna see in this installation, and especially that Emmanuel and his wife Anne will see. So the projection screen will be right behind it and will pass just in front of this piece of furniture. All the rest is gonna be totally invisible. This is gonna be absolutely fabulous. So here, we're gonna have a first surround speaker integrated into the wall. And thanks to the diffusion of these speakers, these Amina speakers, which are invisible, there is very few location of the sound with these speakers. That's why I recommend them. If you can afford them, do it, because it's really, really great. And then the 4 other Atmos speakers are gonna be fixed on the ceiling, and we're gonna have a really diffused sound, a really pleasant sound, uniformly distributed in the living room. So the sofa is right here, and it's gonna be really cool. So how are you feeling about the installation? Are you okay? Yeah, he's on the top. Okay, he's here. It's good. So the other surround speaker is gonna be here. So we're a bit out of step, but you know, when we use wide cone speakers or bipole speakers, human ear has a hard time locating it, so it's gonna be good anyway. So if you use the Amina, there will be no problem at all. So we're gonna make the 15 centimeters formwork so that everything is nicely integrated, and there's gonna be a beautiful LED strip to illuminate the ceiling. So we can't wait to show you all of that and meet you at the end of this product to show you the results. So to understand a little better everything that's at stake with this installation, but you've already understood it by seeing this magnificent house, Anne and Emmanuel certainly have, you know, in view this incredible immersive home cinema experience, but they also want it to be totally integrated and invisible. So here's a little clearer action plan to install this ultra-efficient and practically invisible home cinema. So to begin with, we're gonna use the VW590ES from Sony that we're gonna integrate into our elevator, AluLift HC. Then there's this invisible ceiling screen tensioned, which is gonna fit right into the false ceiling. And then we have our infinity canvas, which is gonna sublimate the content by bringing more depth to the images and offering them a totally abysmal contrast. On the sound side, we're gonna use the fabulous Denon AVC X4700H for a powerful and precise Dolby Atmos experience. And then the famous Definitive Technology RCS2 speakers, which are integrated into the ceiling and which project the sound sound as if it was literally coming out of the canvas. For the surround and Atmos effect, we're gonna make the speakers completely disappear in the partitions thanks to the invisible Amina speakers. To finish in style, two ASW610XP subwoofers are gonna be installated on either side by the sofa. So that's it, you know everything. Now all that remains is to execute the plan. If you too want a crazy and fully integrated Atmos configuration, simply use our Atmos configurator. It's super simple and fast. It's online. First, you create your first ideal configuration in a few clicks, and then we customize it with you. We've got 5 days to do the job, so let's go. So this is the end of the second day of installation. So you saw a lot of pictures. Why? Well, for you, we bought a new camera. A new camera because on the previous one, on the Sony devices, we discovered that we had problems with the microphones. So we had two devices that were malfunctioning. So our newly equipped for you to explain to you everything that's been done. So I'm gonna summarize. The formwork is magnificent. It really starts to take shape. We begin to realize what it's gonna look like. So we already have the pre-made holes for the invisible speakers. So take a good look at them because you're not gonna see them anymore. And then we have the 590ES projector, which is gonna be perfectly focused on the projection surface, which will fall right here. So there you have it. Summary of this day. Everything's okay. All is well. Tomorrow we'll place electrical outlets for the two subwoofers, which we will put at the back of the room, behind you. And there you go. Let's go. Tomorrow is a new day, is a new challenge, and let's go. Alright, well, so you saw us on the various installations. So we've integrated here the Amina speakers in the partition to make the surround speakers. So normally, Amina speakers can be delivered with a back box. This is a box that keeps the sound to prevent it, you know, from going also to the neighbors. But that will also, you know, keep the sound so that the energy comes out only through the speaker. So what we usually do is put expansive foam all around to keep the power in the box that we create behind the wall. The ideal is that. So if you put glass wool, for instance, it will also preserve the sound and keep the energy that will come forward. And that prevents you from having this echo effect that does. I don't know if it's really clear. You must see what I mean. So there, anyway, Just put rock wool behind the speaker. It will be perfect.
Derrière, l'enceinte dessus, ce sera parfait. Ce sera mieux que si vous ne le faites pas.
Hi, so it's a new day. Look at the painting on the ceiling by Ovi. The painting is exceptional. We recommend it to you. Polo, do you validate?
Yeah.
Yeah, he does. So how'd you find this painting? Tell me.
So it's the first time that I'm using it. I'm pretty satisfied because it's 2-in-1. So generally 2-in-1 is never really good because, you know, you have to...
Yeah, it's like shampoo.
Yeah, it's like shampoo. But here, yeah, it's advised by Seigneurie, so it's the best of the best. Here it seems to work really well.
You want to do the same ceiling because it's a little bit technical. Just imagine that the ceiling at the center is really, really smooth, that there are no irregularities that will stand out with the light, right?
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Zero defect because else everything stands out.
And so that painting helps with that too, right?
Yeah, that one's really smooth, really matte, so normally everybody can do it, so...
Okay, here you go, so you can do it all by yourself at home if you want to start a tremendous piece of work. And so... Marwan, you're at the end of your cable work here, right?
Yeah, everything great here.
We're on the top here. Yeah, that's when he's at his best. He's lying down on the ground. So what's it left to pass?
I put everything. There's only this. It remains this to connect, and that's all.
All right. Cool. So there's only this little box here that's left, and so today's Thursday, so tomorrow at noon, we're good, right? Yeah? Yeah, roger that. It's good, we're good. Okay, let's go. Right, so as you can see, the plans are scaled. Yes. Yeah, you just caught us in the act. This is Ousmane, who just joined us. Ousmane is the artist, the great, the fabulous Ousmane. Et du coup, avec vous avez été quelques-uns déjà, je vous ai mis, je vous ai dit, je vous mets en parleur, ça vous dérange pas. Who's gonna take over the implantation, because as we said, there's more and more of it. So he comes with us and he sees how it goes exactly. And so how's it going so far?
Well, it's okay. I just joined the AV concept team and
I've received a very warm welcome.
Good, so is that true?
You're not saying that to be kind, are you?
No.
All right. All right, so now you know who Usman is, and you'll know when you call us, you'll know who this is.
Évidemment, évidemment, on vous laisse pas. Enfin, c'est des choses qui vont se faire sur la durée. Et là, actuellement, on est en train de faire toute la journée que des implantations.
Currently, we're doing all the implantations. It's intense, but
it's intense, but it's okay.
All right. So there, it was just a presentation, so you know who's who. And we also have Avner on the other side and Nasfan. And I'm forgetting someone.
J'oublie quelqu'un.
No, it's okay. Normally, it's okay. We'll talk about it soon, and you'll get to know the team a little better as you go. So there it is.
Petite entrevue sur cette installation.
So here I am, disturbing the plasterboard magicians Ovi and Eve. I just wanted to show you something. Look, come here and come and see inside. So, here it is. If you put a traditional speaker in here, well, you would hear a lot of echo, a lot of resonance, a lot of disturbance in the ceiling. That is why it's super important to use closed speakers, especially for the central speaker. It's the most important speaker in the installation, so here's the most energy in the whole installation. So these closed speakers will allow for two things. First of all, it will prevent the sound from disturbing the neighbors above, so if it's children, that's a good thing. And it will also allow to have a better sound in the enclosure. So when you have an open ceiling like that, beware, because otherwise the sound can be very, very poor. Little parenthesis to tell you about our partner Denon, which is part of Sound United. So Sound United is this huge universe of brands that are in the top of home cinema. So that's Denon, Marantz, Definitive Technology. So we use them every time, all the time. It's the kind of speakers that give you a very frontal sound, even though they're dispatched on the sides. It's Polk also. And the newcomer, Bowers and Wilkins. So in short, they've taken the whole audio market. Everything that's best, it's them. So the team is really great, and as a professional, when you have a problem, problems are normal, problems are human.
Quand vous avez un problème, quand vous avez, parce que ça peut arriver, c'est des produits qui sont fabriqués par les hommes, donc par nature, on peut avoir un problème.
But you need to have someone to talk to, and that would be Jan Gazy, for instance. And he's here to help untangle when there's a problem. He helps untangling problems for us. So in short, that's why we talk about Denon all the time. And that 4700H that we're going to install here is the last generation. It was made available last year. So what's about it? It's the first 8K device, so you don't necessarily need 8K on the content that you usually watch, but something is really cool. And that would be here, IMAX Enhanced. This is fabulous.
IMAX Enhanced. Et ça, ça c'est un truc qui est vraiment vraiment fabuleux. Vous avez, bah, vous connaissez le Dolby Vision, qui est un truc.
You already know about Dolby Vision. Which has been around for a while, which is a specific HDR image processing developed by Dolby. And so you have IMAX. IMAX is another format, you know about it. There are several formats, but IMAX is a hyper-immersive format. And the sound is particular, and the image is particular. And the directors who direct on IMAX are among the directors who really have a particular intention with their content to convey particular emotion, particular information and immersion.
Une attention particulière avec leur contenu d'avoir le contenu qui est retransmis de cette manière-là parce qu'il y a ce côté immersif qui est pas d'ailleurs pendant tout le film, d'accord?
Vous avez souvent. So you often have 235 format and then boom, it goes to IMAX. So Christopher Nolan's the king of that with Batman, with Dunkirk, and it really brings that dimension to you.
Vous avez vraiment quelque chose qui, enfin, ça vous apporte vraiment beaucoup plus dans le contenu et beaucoup plus d'immersion et compréhension du film.
So what about IMAX Enhanced? IMAX Enhanced is on one side is the sound DTS and DTS:X, so that audio immersive universe, and so it can be calibrated with the IMAX.
Donc c'est ce côté immersif sonore qui va être calibré d'une de standardiser.
So that you have the best sound coming directly from your amplifier. And you have exactly the same thing on the picture. So when you have a chain of devices that are compatible, and your Blu-ray as well, you have the whole chain of devices that is compatible, and you're gonna get the best out of your installation. And so you're directly on the right settings. And this amplifier does it. We're going to show it to you. So you're going to access to a menu that you do not usually have access to. And you're going to see if your content has IMAX. And then you'll access specific settings. And so we're going to show that to you later.
Normalement, s'il est IMAX, vous allez le voir sur le petit écran s'afficher. Et vous aurez ensuite accès à des réglages qui sont vraiment spécifiques à ce mode-là.
It was a bit long, but I hope it was interesting.
J'espère que c'était un truc qui était intéressant.
So that's one of the particular that we really love about it, especially when you use it with the 590ES. Right now, let's open the box and see what happens.
Maintenant, je déballe et on fait ça ensemble.
Ta-da! Here it is. Yeah, look at that. Look at that. Marwan did an absolutely wonderful job. So where do we start? If you're used to that, we have these sockets here. What you want to do? The battery, of course. The battery is what will allow us to locate our speakers. So an interesting fact to know about the Amina speakers is that they have inbuilt filters. And the filters cut the sound. So when you use the battery to hear to locate the speaker, it's going to work the first time, but it's not going to work the second time. So the thing to do is to flip the battery around in order to make it work. Look at that. Come on. Here. So, can you actually see something here? No, you can't. Right answer. You just have one speaker in here, and then you have the worst light coming in from here. Are you able to see something? No. Because it's an artist's job. It was Ovi who joined us. And it was already great before, but now we're in another sphere, we're on another universe of performance. So this is gonna be really beautiful.
Okay, so I'm in slow motion.
So Ahmed filmed that in slow motion, but it doesn't really, really matter since you can still understand. Anyway, what I want you to understand is that the two subwoofers are going to be placed on one side and the other of the room. Two different places is a good thing if they're not stuck together, because the sound waves are gonna cross, and so you're gonna have a more harmonious sound, and it will prevent the sound from being too loud. So that's what I just explained to you in slow motion. Are you recording? Yeah, okay, good. So, what you see here is one of our last ASW610XP. So, this is the box that we love. We use it for each of your installations because it's really simple, it's efficient, the design is really cool, and it allows you to have a really great experience of sound. Be careful, Ahmed, do not fall into the pool. So, yeah, it allows you to have a great experience. I'm a little breathless here. This box is heavy. So, in short, this 610XP subwoofer is a great device that allows you to have, you know, when you put two of them, to have really great harmony. Oh my god, it feels good when there's no vacuum. I hope you heard what I said before. So, two subwoofers we dispatch in two different places, and that will allow us to have, you know, when we're in a small room, so a small acoustic room is 15 meters by 15 meters. All our rooms are generally small, so please don't take it personally when we say it's a small room. So the waves bounce back and forth, and if you miss the waves from one subwoofer, then you catch the waves from the other, and that helps you to have more harmonious sound. That's why we put two of them. So that's one of the last 610XPs that we have, so there's a lot of emotion here installing it. It's gonna be one of the last videos you'll see it in, and we don't know what we're gonna have from Bowers and Wilkins because they have not yet announced what they have. So for the moment, we have no other speakers. About the quotes for the next installations, you might be surprised by having another subwoofer. We will have a solution, but I just don't know which one yet. Let's unpack it. And in any case, it's a great product. There might be a 620XP. Who knows? All right, what are we doing in this room? A few moments ago, we're still at Anne and Emmanuel's house. This is just an additional part of the video that was shot later. But I really wanted to tell you about this IMAX Enhanced experience, which I told you about just before. Here we are now in the showroom, doing a little cut in the middle of the video, so I have the opportunity to present to you what I had in mind while we were at the house. So the first thing to know is the IMAX. Here, we're with this demo Blu-ray CD. It's exactly the same one that we used to do the demo to Emmanuel, Anne, and their whole family to show them all the benefits that they could have with this system. So, what about the IMAX? It's the sound, it's the format, it's the image, of course, and all of that is gathered together thanks to the collaboration of two entities that you may already know. IMAX, you know about them. So these are these huge screens that you have in large cinema rooms. and they have very specific characteristics. We're not going to go through the entire history of IMAX, but what makes the particularity of it is the format of the image, which is often extremely high compared to other formats. So it's practically 4 over 3, and it's a very high format compared to what we might usually know, which gives you a very immersive effect that is extraordinary. The second thing is that the speakers inside the IMAX rooms are extremely specific, since unlike in a classic home cinema, you don't have this 0.1, so 5.1, 7.1. The 0.1 represents the LFE, so the low frequency effect. These are the low frequency, the bass, that are sent to the subwoofer. So you can have more than one, of course, but the speakers, therefore, are a lot smaller. They go until a specific frequency, and then the subwoofers take over, you know, to give you the bass in the room. In an IMAX cinema, it's really different because every speaker is full range. You have the set of all frequencies available integrated into each speaker, so every speaker can go from the lowest to the highest frequencies, and that is what makes the IMAX experience really special. The other thing is that IMAX is such a specific format that it is the people from IMAX themselves who mix the films, who master the films. So the director will shoot the movie in IMAX, but then IMAX will process the image and will then reproduce it to get the final content. So the artist who realizes the film is always the same, but the people who are going to process the image are IMAX. So no other company does that, as far as I know, for the cinema. All these peculiarities mean that reproducing the IMAX experience is a really, really complex thing to do and was not easy to do until now. But now you have this new format, IMAX Enhanced. Blu-ray already existed before, so for instance, Mission Impossible Fallout is a good example. It was filmed in Atmos and IMAX, so you're gonna have the format that's gonna vary from one moment to the other. It's really immersive. But here, IMAX Enhanced is really the quintessence of what IMAX is able to do, because the movie released in IMAX Enhanced was specifically mastered by the IMAX laboratories. So that will give you a much more contrasted experience. So I put some parts of the demo videos for you. We show you before and after. So you're gonna have specific film grain that gives the cinema aspect, especially with digital cameras. And when you put that on the projector, it's rather flattering actually compared to a TV, because even when you have a 4K TV or 8K TV, it's gonna see that grain as chunks of the picture. So it's gonna be like little sparks all over the place. And this is due to the grain, to that film grain of the image, which is embedded into the film. And what IMAX Enhanced does is that they're gonna process that image to make it smoother, but they're gonna still keep that cinematic effect. And that's what you'll be able to see right here. But when you're in front of the screen, even with the projector, it's really, really neat. So the first thing is this video effect. If the whole chain is compatible, if your Blu-ray player is compatible, if the amplifiers are compatible, the 8500H, the 4500H, as in Anne and Emmanuel's house, if the projectors are compatible, the 790ES, the 590ES, if all of that is compatible, then you'll be able to benefit from this IMAX Enhanced experience. Therefore, once you have that, you're gonna see, and this is what I wanted to show you, you're gonna see the menu right here on the amplifier display. So if you press the movie button, then you immediately have this menu popping up. So you can read IMAX DTS:X. It's a partnership between IMAX, which is format and image, but is proprietary, and DTS, which is Dolby's main competitor. So DTS:X is object-based sound, just like Dolby Atmos, for instance, and will be merged with IMAX and will give you additional possibilities. So all of your home cinema system, if you have an Atmos or DTS:X system, will be a better system. You'll have a better bass management, a calibrated bass management compared to the content, which is IMAX Enhanced. So if you don't like it, you can still deactivate that. And if you like it, then you can still make little adjustments. Still, to do this, it's really simple. You have a content that's playing, I put it on pause, so we'll go to audio. The image and the sound are in audio. Then we go to surround parameters. And then you have this menu that only shows up when you have IMAX Enhanced content, which is in your source, which is accessible. So you're gonna have the IMAX here. Either you can put it to auto, generally if you can leave it to auto, it works fine, but you can also turn it off. And then it will deactivate all the process. And then you also have the audio parameters specific to IMAX Enhanced. So for example, you have low pass, high pass filters. Because, as I said, the particularity of the IMAX speakers is to have all the frequencies available on each speaker. In a traditional 5.1 system, what will happen is that the speakers are gonna unload the bass frequencies on the subwoofers. But here, what the amplifier does, it will have detected what your speakers are capable of doing. So, for instance, it will be able to play the LFE signal in low range for all speakers. This means that here, the signal, the low frequency effect signal, is sent on all of the speakers. So this is a great trick if you have big speakers. We don't normally put huge speakers all around, but here the RCS2s in the ceiling from Definitive Technology do the job quite well. So if you have all of those all around you, it can be pretty phenomenal. So this system allows you to activate it or not. Again, you can leave it on auto, but it's a nice trick to know. Because, you know, this format is not yet well known. A lot of content is about to come. I can't wait to see that, and I'll let you watch this demo. I hope we're gonna be okay on the copyright side. So normally the excerpts are quite short, and this is for you so you can see quite a bit the result that it can give. So I'm staying silent. The sound is captured by the microphone, which is in the room. So there, this is my little gift for you. I'll leave you to that, and then we go back to the installation. Let's go! So there, I hope this IMAX Enhanced demo has allowed you to feel what this content can bring to you. On our side, we can't wait to see the new IMAX movies, so feel free to leave a message to let us know if you've ever watched IMAX Enhanced movies before, and if you want us to cover the subject in more detail in a future video. Here are some beautiful images of the final result of this installation. Personally, I'm a fan of the decoration, and the immersion is just incredible. Tell us what you think, and as usual, if you haven't done it already, subscribe and like this video. I also wanted to thank you all, you, our followers, our beloved clients who trust us, and also all the members of the AV Concept team.
Soila, Paul Avner, Espoir, Marwan, Novi, Hugo, Berenice, Ousmane, Ahmed, Johanna.
Thank you so much for being here. So here we are. I really wanted to say that. See you next week and have a nice weekend. Bye.